We have some very special guests in the studio this morning, the New Guinea singing dog puppies. And they're coming to us from the Shy Wolf Sanctuary.
What a fun breed they are. We have Deanna Deppin joining us this morning, the director of the Shy Wolf Sanctuary. And thanks so much for joining us, guys, this morning and bringing in Ozzy and Groot.
And yes. Karen is helping over there as
and
well.
They are sweet as can be and very well-tempered dogs. For being dogs, I guess you would consider to be of the wild.
Florida classifies them as a wild canine. They're still found in Papua New Guinea. That's the only place in the world that you can find this canine.
Interesting.
And they are pretty much full grown. They get to be about 25 pounds, maybe 30 at the max. These guys are about 7-8 months old. We were contacted to help adopt them out.
And this
they can be pets.
Ozzy here.
They are a primitive breed. They're very cat-like and independent in that regard. They're very clean canines. I have some at home that also know how to use a litter box.
Oh, really?
Oh, now that
wow.
is talent.
Yeah.
Now, these dogs, again, are only found in one place in the world in the wild, and they were thought to be extinct up until recently, correct?
Until 2012.
Until 2012.
And the first research was done in 2016. They're actually called the New Guinea Highland Wild Dog in the wild.
Oh, wow.
And so they're not even called the singing dog, but they are... they make this unique vocalization that people are studying. And when that person got the photo of the guy in 2012 of the dog, they actually started doing research. So the first research published wasn't until 2020, last
wow,
year.
Wow, really? That recently?
Some of our rescued singing dogs are actually a part of that study where they compared the DNA of the captive bred dogs to the wild dogs.
These are, as cute as they are, we were just talking about, and their classification is different than a domesticated dog. What are some of the challenges that one might face if they brought these dogs into their homes?
They dig, they climb, they're very athletic. They actually have the ability to flip their heads back to look behind them.
Oh,
wow.
Like an owl could see behind them. They can rotate their forearms, so they have been known to climb trees before,
okay.
like a cat, like I said, very cat-like.
Wow.
They have the unique vocalizations, which, even though they're like apartment condo-sized dogs, mm-hmm. could make it challenging to have them. They respond to sirens, so they love our first responders.
Yeah.
Whenever they hear a siren, they start singing.
Oh, great.
Oh, really?
Now, did they give us a little preview of their singing earlier? Is it just kind of like this, kind of sound, or is it? Let's hear you guys.
What is that?
I don't know if they'll do it outside their normal
See,
territory.
Do they harmonize?
That gets their attention.
And the thing is if you want to adopt dogs just like this, I mean, it's almost like you have to find the perfect marriage for them.
We do.
Perfect pairing.
We're very careful with our screening. We, you know, we do have an application process. We do reference checks, vet checks. We do home visits.
A little bit of it.
We always stand behind the dogs, too, that we adopt. Whether it's a wolf dog or a singing dog, we are there to help if there's an issue or to take it back. Groot actually had a home. Groot's the one in the red.
Okay.
He had a home. It was only about 2 weeks before we got the call saying their dog was being too rough with him.
Oh,
so
really?
It wasn't anything he did. It was the other dog did not accepting him. So that's
okay.
why we're trying to find homes closer to where we are so we can help
sure.
introduce and manage that process.
If our viewers aren't familiar with the Shy Wolf Sanctuary is, tell us a little bit about what you do and what your mission is.
Our mission is to heal hearts and minds through rescue, sanctuary, and education. Our founders rescued their first animal in 1993. It was a three-legged leopard, actually.
Oh, wow. Much for being here. And obviously, if you are interested in seeing these pups or maybe adopting one, you can visit the Shy Wolf Sanctuary. We have their information on the screen. You do need to call ahead, of course. We'll put this on our website as well. That's abc-7.com. Thank you all so much for being here. We appreciate